Hello and welcome to You're Still. You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we look at Event Grid and special machine learning events coming directly from Azure Machine Learning Service. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show, part 2 of 3. We've been talking about MLOps with Shivani. How you doing, my friend?
I'm good. How are you?
Fantastic. Tell us who you are and what you do.
All right, so I'm Shivani. I work on the Azure Machine Learning Platform team. I'm a program manager, and I specifically work on MLOps.
Fantastic. So what are we talking about for this episode?
So today I'm going to talk about Event Grid and how you can create event-driven workflows and a little bit about, you know, why it's important and what you can do with it.
All right, so let's start with what Event Grid actually is.
Definitely. So Event Grid is basically a message routing service. It enables you to subscribe to events from different event sources and consume and trigger them in a bunch of different event handlers.
I see. So it's basically like an eventing system for all of Azure stuff.
Exactly. Exactly.
Fantastic. So what can you do with machine learning and Event Grid?
Great question. So basically, Azure Machine Learning Service is an event source now. So what you can do is use Event Grid to subscribe to a variety of different machine learning events going on in your AML workspace.
And why would this be something that you'd like to do?
For sure. So why is it useful, right? So it's because in an end-to-end machine learning workflow, there basically isn't a single pipeline that's going to enable you to do this end-to-end. Right, there's a variety of different tools, a variety of different activities that you have to support. So by using something like Event Grid, you can integrate a bunch of different workflows end to end and then have a full view of what's going on in your machine learning workflow. So this could be scenarios like retraining your model when you have new data or your model is degrading over time. Another common scenario is, you know, just let me know what's going on in my training pipeline. If my run is failing or if it's been queued for too long, just send me an email so I can go in and fix what's going on there. And then lastly, you can also just get a full view on what's going on by streaming events, all events happening in your training pipeline or your deployment pipeline into an event hub.
Oh, it sounds really cool, but I feel like I want to look at something now.
For sure. So let's try this out. I'm going to go over to the Azure portal right here. And so what you initially want to do is go into your machine learning workspace, click on events and event subscriptions. And right here, you can basically select what event types you want to subscribe to.
I see. So can you describe what those 5 events are?
For sure. So right here, the events are model registration, model deployment, and run completion data set drift detected. So what these events basically are is that when this action happens, successfully, for example, if a run is completed successfully, you'll get an alert. The only one that's a little bit different is run status change. So let's say you're doing a training run and it gets queued, it's finalizing or it's failing, those type of events will get streamed or triggered through a run status changed event.
I see. So like, do you create a set of events for different things, or is there a way to filter on this stuff? Like, I feel like I want to learn a little bit more about this.
For sure. So I need to stop saying for sure. But basically, you'll go into your filters here, and you'll add a new filter. And let's say, you know, I only want to get runs for pipeline runs. What I'll do is say for data type, you know, run type, I will go ahead and say, you know, when the string or is equal to or is in a Azure Machine Learning pipeline. So right here, as I showed you, what will happen is for this event that I'm triggering or setting up subscription for, only pipeline runs will trigger the event.
So in Event Grid, you can create any number of events for any number of things, any combination of those 5 events, and then filter them in any way to send out information anywhere.
Definitely. So the data that's collected for each of these events is things like, you know, model ID, model version, tags, description. So there's a lot of venues to customize and filter your events.
That's cool. So can we see this in action?
For sure. So we'll talk about, you know, what you can do with these events. So you want to send these events to a particular endpoint. For this example, I'll talk about logic apps.
Can we go back 1 second? Because I want to see the, let's go back and let's look at the event endpoint types. I see. So anytime these things are fired off, basically if it matches the filter, if it matches the event for that particular event subscription, you can send it to any one of these things to do anything.
Definitely.
Awesome. Okay.
Yep. So the type that I'm looking at today, which actually shows up as webhook in the UI, is a logic app right here. So what I'll first do is set up a listener into event grid. So right here, I'm saying, all right, so every time my run is completed, send me an email alert. So I'll specify the workspace and information here. And now I'm going to send myself an email every time this happens. What's really great is that you can create a bunch of different workflows with this. It doesn't need to be a single action that can be taken based on an event. So along with sending an email, I could even, you know, create a work item in my Azure DevOps project and say, here's a bug, you know, the run failed, you know, go investigate it and assign it to a specific person. So it's really, really powerful in creating, you know, infinite workflows.
I see. So if you're trying to do the actual MLOps, there's a number of different business requirements depending on what's happening for the events that you could wire up and glue together with either logic apps, looks like you've got Azure Functions, and even just basic plain old webhooks.
Definitely. And so one really interesting advanced scenario that I talked about earlier is, you know, retraining, right? So we have on Azure Machine Learning data set drift detection, and you can set that up in your Azure Machine Learning workspace. So right here, I just have a data set monitor that is going to look at the input data set coming into my deployed model and compare it to this baseline data set to make sure the difference isn't too much, right? So I've set a threshold to say, okay, if the difference between the two data sets is a lot, you know, send me an alert. So I'll use Event Grid for that. Now, I don't only want to get an alert. Let's say I want to do retraining. So I'll set up in Azure Data Factory a way to copy new data over and trigger my machine learning training pipeline to retrain and output a new model. So once I've set these individual components up, I'll go back to my logic app and tie all these together. So what I'll do here is, you know, I'll set a listener in, you know, in my workspace. If dataset drift is detected, that event gets created, and then it triggers my Azure Data Factory pipeline right here. And then within the Data Factory, as you saw, I'm triggering my training pipeline. And so every time that happens, this workflow will just continuously repeat.
So what you're saying then is that whenever there is a data set drift detection, which means that the data has changed, this will automatically send an event from Event Grid to this logic app, which will tell Data Factory, copy some data over and retrain the machine learning pipeline. Is that right?
Yes, exactly.
Fantastic. Well, thank you so much for spending some time with us. And again, thank you so much for watching. This is part 2 of 3, learning all about MLOps. We learned about Event Grid in this one. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time. Take care.